Today, we'll give some introduction to the Vedic Dharma. My name is Sagar Garg. So, let's get started. So, Vedic scriptures are originally four Vedas. They are Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, and Atharva Veda. Veda simply means knowledge. They contain all kinds of knowledge, physical, spiritual, and social sciences as well. So they are the oldest books on earth. Basically, they are the manual for the world. Just like a manufacturer makes something, they make a manual for it. So how to use it, what it's for, how to take care of it. Same way, the creator of the universe made this universe, and he gave us this manual for the human beings. What is for, what you are supposed to do, why you are there. Same way, so they were revealed in the beginning of creation, so nobody gets deprived of this knowledge and wisdom. Then the first language on the earth, that was Sanskrit. There are no history, stories, places, or people in the Vedas, not even the author of the Vedas. There are many commentaries on the Vedas, such as Gita, Upanishads, and many more. So they are supposed to be based on the Vedas. And there are historical books. There are many, but two are main, Mahabharata and Ramayana. We'll discuss this 10 important points which are from the Vedas. The first one is from Rig Veda. It says it tells you to become human, you know, to have humanly qualities. They don't talk about any faith. They just tell you to become a human, be truthful, be kind, be helpful, be honest, and all those good qualities to have. Number two, they tell you that all living beings, animals, humans, they all have Atma or soul. So starting from the ant to the elephant to the human beings, they all have Atma. Number three, they tell you to treat animals ethically, because we all know that they feel the same pain as humans do. And who knows, you know, next time we may be one of them. Number four, reincarnation is real. After bodily death, the soul or the Atma gets new life, all based on your own karma. So you can become a human being, or you can become a non-human as well. Number five, as you sow, so shall you reap, is the God's justice system. So there is no partiality, there is no favoritism. All you do, that's what you get back. So all based on your own karma. Number six, destiny. You make your own destiny. It's not like some God gives you, you know, this much you get, this much you get. You know, after the birth, some karma is saved that comes as a destiny. So you make your own destiny based on your own karma. Number seven, your Atma is yours through eternity. You cannot change it, you cannot replace it, you cannot exchange with anybody else. So it's always there, you are always there, it's you. So you have to take care of it, so, you know, so that you gain the best out of it. Number eight, heaven and hell are situations, and there are no particular places according to the Vedas. Excuse me. So when you're in having good time, you feel you're in heaven, and when you're not having good time or having a bad time, then basically you're in hell. Simple as that. Number nine, God is never born. He's the creator of the universe, he does the justice, he is omnipresent, there is not a place where he's not. So he's everywhere and everything, including you and me. So he's everywhere, and that's why he's omniscient. He knows everything, what's going on, because he's everywhere. He can see it. He knows what you're thinking, what you're speaking, what you're doing. So everything he knows. He's omnipotent, means he's all powerful. So that means he can do all his works by himself. Nobody else can help him to create the sun, the moon, the earth, and all these plants, you know, stars and all that, those things. So that does not mean, omnipresent does not mean he can do anything and everything, because he will not go against his own justice system, against his own laws. He cannot do favors. He cannot create another God. He cannot kill himself. So things like that. But basically, he does all his works by himself. There is nobody can help him. Number 10, therefore, God, since God is everywhere, is also within you. So not only within you, when person dies, the body stays, but the Atma takes off. But God is also in the Atma. Therefore, we are just an Atma. And if you want to meet God, you want to meditate God, you want to talk to God, it can be done only in your Atma, in your own soul. Because God is everywhere, but you are not. You are only a soul. So this is, so we can approach him directly within your own Atma. Thanks for watching.